Student, in this lecture, we are going to learn about virtual circuit network in unit 4, network layer. So, what is network layer? The network layer is responsible for routing, carrying the packet from source all the way to destination. In short, it's responsible for host-to-host delivery. There is one network layer process associated with each node and with each external size of the network. It transports segment from sending to receiving host. On sending side, encapsulate segment into datagrams. On receiving side, deliver segment to transport layer. The network layer has a higher responsibility than the data link layer when I compare with data link layer, because the data link layer is only supposed to move from the frames from one end of the wire to the other end. Thus, the network layer is the lowest layer that deals with the end-to-end transmission. It deals with a transport layer. Fine. After this, network layer protocol in every host and router and router examine header fields in all IP datagram passing through it. Network layer connection or connectionless service. And datagram network provide network layer connectionless service. While virtual circuit network provides network layer connection service. So what is virtual circuit? A virtual circuit is a circuit which is cross between circuit switches network. It has some characteristics. As in a circuit switch network, there are step and tear down phases in addition to the data transfer phase. Resources can be allocated during the setup phase as in a circuit switch network or on demand as in a datagram network. As in a circuit switch network, all packets follow the same path established during the connection. As we can see, a virtual circuit consists of path between the source and destination host and virtual circuit number, one number for each link along the path. Entries in the forwarding table in each router along the path. So this is a connection between a source and a destination. When a source sends data, firstly he want to establish a connection with receiver. So he initiate a call, and this call which is initiated by a source is accepted by the receiver only, and a connection between a source and destination builds. After that, data flow begins or data flow start by a source side, and this data is received by receiver. So this kind of connection is built between the source and receiver. A packet belong to virtual circuit will carry a VC number in its header. See, every packet or datagram having a VC number so that router can identify which data is transferred to which receiver. So VC number can be changed one each link by forwarding table. This is virtual circuit network. Here is a source and here is a destination, and between this intermediate state here which contains so many switches. So what is forwarding table? A forwarding table between a source and a receiver is a simplest table who contains four parts. And this four parts containing important information about a virtual circuit. So first part is incoming interface, second is incoming VC, third is outgoing interface, and fourth one is outgoing VC. So incoming interface is used to define that the frame arriving from which port. See, here is a port number 1 as an incoming interface. So a frame arriving at port number 1 with VC number is 12, incoming VC is 12, so it we can say with VC number 14 or VC number 12, whatever is given here. And outgoing interface is defined that on which port the frame will be sended by the source, and this is outgoing VC number. So there are three phases in a virtual circuit, and these phases are data transfer phase, setup phase, and teardown phase. So first we are discuss data transfer phase. In data transfer phase, there are two situations. First one is switch and table, and second one is source to destination. So first we are discuss about switch and table. To transfer a frame from a source to its destination, from source to its destination, all switches need to have a table entry from this virtual circuit. As I told you, this table is a simplest table, or we can say it is a forwarding table. See, this is a forwarding table here only, having a port number 1. Port number 1. So we can say this port number 1 means frame arriving from port number 1. Frame arriving at port number 1 with VC number 14 here. Fine. When the frame arrives, the switches look in its table to find out port 1 and a VC of 14. When it is found, the switch knows to change the VC to 22 and send out frame from port 3. The data transfer phase is active until the source and source send all its frame to the destination. It's only dedicated to send data from source to destination. And the procedure at the switch is the same for each frame of a message, and the process circuit, not a real circuit, between the source and destination, it is a virtual circuit. So this is a source to destination. Here we having a forwarding table. Here we having a forwarding table, and data is transferred from a source to destination port, and port number 1 having data with VC number 14, and it is outgoing port is port number 3 here and VC number 16 here. So I hope you are able to understand about data transfer phase, and after this we will continue in our next lecture with setup phase and teardown phase. Fine. Thank you.